I'm John Keister, and welcome to Almost Live Presents the Battle of the Sexes. And you know, over the years, I've had a few relationships with members of the opposite sex, and I'm even married, so I guess that counts as one. But I've never really fully understood exactly how that relationship works, the relationship between man and woman. And fortunately, Bill Nye, the science guy, our science expert, is here, and he says that science will help me understand this. So, Bill, please, take it away.
Thank you, John. Yes. The relationship between men and women, John, is basically chemical. Chemistry.
Right, I've heard that.
Okay, so we have here a chemical model, which I think will enlighten us. This is water, ordinary water. It's tasteless. It would be colorless, but we've added a little food coloring. It's bland, boring. So that represents the man.
The man, sure.
Now,
okay.
This is vegetable oil. It's got some thickness. It's interesting, some texture.
Yeah. Okay.
That represents the woman.
Sure.
Now, you see, as I mix them, they interact.
Oh, yeah, sure, yeah.
A little bit of a party going there. They're kind of dancing at first.
Uh-huh.
But then just after a very brief period, they separate into two distinct layers.
So the fun's over.
Roughly, yes, John.
That
and
was
you see,
fast.
The
that
thing,
was fast.
That's right. Yes. They can stay like this for a long time. As long as nobody crosses that line, crosses that interface, they will coexist here in the laboratory for years.
Mm.
Now this, as I say, is a laboratory model, laboratory representation.
Yeah.
This is not really like the real world. To make it like the real world, we will add this chemical, which has some elements of the real world. Let's say, for example, this chemical represents a joint checking account.
Oh, okay.
I'm going to add it to the model.
Oh, yeah, okay.
See,
there.
Right away.
Now that looks familiar.
Yeah,
yeah, I understand.
Let me show you a little feature.
Whoa! Yeah, okay. Well, it's all very clear to me now. Thank you very much, Bill.
Almost Live presents The Battle of the Sexes. Featuring Pat Cashman, Tracy Conway, Bob Nelson, Bill Nye, Bill Stainton, Steve Wilson, and Ed Wyatt, and starring John Keister. And tonight, a special look at the complicated world of friendships, relationships, courtships, and sometimes abandonships. It's affairs of the heart, matters of love, and other mushy stuff. As Almost Live wages the battle of the sexes. And now, here's John Keister.
Thank you. Thank you. Good evening. Good evening and welcome to Almost Live Presents the Battle of the Sexes. And I want to say right off the top that there's no battle of the sexes in my life, because I surrendered. I gave it. I threw in the towel, and please don't call me a wimp, don't call me a mama's boy or a sniveling little worm man. Just call me a codependent. Call me a codependent. I like it. How many codependents do we have here tonight? Okay, pretty much, good, most of us. I like that, I really like that. Or maybe I don't, I don't know, I'll have to call home and check. But anyway, in my experience with the interaction between the sexes, I've always thought that it was expensive, for one thing, over $2 a minute sometimes. But, you know, I think the real problem is communication. And when this problem gets extreme, it can lead to situations like this. Now, this is a real ad that we saw in the Little Nickel personal ad section this week. Take a look at this. Do you see this? 1/3 carat total diamond weight wedding set, trade for handgun plus cash. Please leave me. Now you see, absolutely, somewhere behind that ad is a man or a woman who just never understood that there are some basic differences between men and women. And now these differences can be easily forgotten, so we thought a refresher course would be a good idea. For example, women like to take romantic walks on the beach at sunset. Men like to watch things blow up. Good. Now, men are secretly in love with Katarina Witt. Women think she's a bitch. Very good. Follow along at home. Women
want a man with a successful career. Men want women with a successful career in modeling, in money. Finally, a man seeks a mate who is attractive, smart, and shares common interests. A woman seeks a mate who will eventually get a vasectomy. You see? Some validation there. And you see, those misunderstandings, that's why it's so hard for single people to get together. But fortunately, in this day and age, we've got lots of ways to help. Singles clubs, personal ads, singles bars, singles cruises, all that stuff. It's so much fun looking for the right person. So singles, pay attention.
So you're single and you want more dates?
Yes, I would like to meet
you. You have come to the right place. This is the greatest singles club. I mean, you are going to have such a fun time here. I mean, nobody can even believe we are single. We have such a great time, and oh, you'll just fit right in. You will be one of us. Oh, everybody, she's gonna join. Oh, yay!
Welcome you. I guarantee results. With my video dating service, you will always get a date. Okay, let me turn this on here. You ready?
I'm ready.
Okay, good. Is it too hot in here? Are you hot? Are you cold?
Hot.
Okay, good. And, oh, I forgot. Did you want coffee?
I want it.
Okay, good.
I want it. I'm hot. I'm ready.
I would, but I'm afraid I might get killed by those earrings. Might puncture my
Yeah, lungs. You might just slip on all your BS.
Well, then at least I wouldn't be here, would I?
Oh, my broken heart. Where will I go?
Well, just
what
remember, just do? Remember, it's been a little slice of heaven for me too, dear.
Yeah. So Steve and Wendy said you're a really neat guy, and I trust their opinion, so I thought...
Yeah, they've been real good to me ever since Karen died. And I think it's time I should get on with my life, and I think they're right.
When did she die?
Last Thursday. So what movie did you rent?
Maybe we should just watch The Simpsons. Okay.
Okay.
You're back! Hey, everybody, she's back! Oh,
we welcome you back!
All right, we've got to make a commercial now, so make a prank phone call to your old boyfriend or girlfriend and join us again.
I'm in banking.
Oh.
How about you?
I sell real estate.
Interesting field?
Well, I guess sometimes.
Sounds a lot like banking.
Welcome back to Almost Live Presents the Battle of the Sexes. And being a man, I tend to look at relationships from a man's point of view, which is generally kind of fuzzy because of the scotch, the Jägermeister, the brew. But anyway. But recently, my wife and I were having a calm adult conversation about some of our differences, and after I got all the glass swept up, she enlightened me about some of the things that women look for in a man. For example, women look for intelligence, sensitivity, and a nice tight little butt. Some of you didn't know that. They look for a man who grasps the cold water, gentle cycle concept. A woman likes a man who sings like Pavarotti but doesn't look like him. She likes a man with a sense of humor about psychotic PMS outbursts. And most importantly, a woman looks for a man who thinks cellulite is kind of cute. Oh, more validation. Unfortunately, women don't often find these and other important qualities in the men that they meet, but this is starting to change thanks to institutions like this one.
Hello. This is adult education, and this course is foreign language for males. I'm your instructor, Emily Crowther. We're going to start off the class with a classic. Take a look here. Anyone want to try and say this here? Anyone? Okay, I'll say it with you. I love. Love. Okay, that's all right, don't worry. We'll try something a little easier. All right, everyone say this together. Let's just sit and talk for a while. Let's
just sit.
All right. Dave, why don't you try it?
Let's just get a little more comfortable.
No, just sit and talk for a while.
Sit and talk for a while.
Good. All right, now everyone again.
Let's just sit and talk for a while.
Good, much better. Okay, let's all say, I don't know. Oh, come on, it's three words. Let's say it. No.
I don't know.
Good. Ken, I'll ask you a question and you answer. What's thermal conductivity?
Oh, that's easy. Everyone knows that. That's the temperature on the top of the television set when it's been on for...
Ken! Try again. What's thermal conductivity?
I don't know.
Excellent. All right, everyone together. I don't know. Great! You are doing great, really. Okay, one more. I'm ready to make... a commitment. Okay, everybody.
Well, apparently we're not quite ready for a class like that, so I guess no matter how in touch we men get with our inner child, no matter how many Robert Bly books we read, when it's all said and done, we'd rather be watching monster trucks. Yeah, I mean, you know. But still, women have some recourse. If their man just isn't getting it, they can always send him to the male clinic.
We've been driving for the last hour and a half. We are lost.
We are not lost.
Yes, we are. Why don't we just go back to that service station and ask for directions?
I cannot ask for directions.
Why not? What's going to happen to you if you ask for directions?
I'll die. Okay?
Are you a man with bad, evil male habits?
Honey, you've got a serious problem. Now, would you please call and get some help?
Okay. But would you call for me? You know how I hate to use the phone.
Call the Male Clinic. We can cure what's ailing you.
All right, Ron, go ahead. Ask directions.
Can I help you?
I can't do it. I can't do it! Can you tell me how to get to the freeway?
Very good. Here's your cookie.
The Male Clinic has several therapies to choose from, including physical therapy, sensory deprivation for chronic remote control problems.
Can someone
the same channel for 10 minutes.
And we specialize in electric shock therapy for swivel neck and unsightly scratching.
Okay, scratch.
Oh.
Good. Scratch. Good. Scratch. Good. Scratch.
No bad habit is too tough to handle, even chronic self-deception.
I see here that you frequently tell people that you could have played professional football.
Well, yeah, I was recruited by a couple of colleges, but I chose not to make that my career. But sure, I could hold my own in the pros. Absolutely.
I have a couple of people I'd like you to meet. Andy Heck, Brian Millard, the Seattle Seahawks. Let's see you get past them.
Well, I don't have my cleats on right now, and I should probably limber up, you know, a little bit.
Now!
Okay, stay with us. When we come back, we'll take a look at the other side of the coin when we visit the female clinic, so stay tuned.
You are really something.
Yeah, well, that really was nice.
Well, welcome back to Almost Live Presents the Battle of the Sexes. And you know, it seems like I can't even walk down the street without gorgeous women throwing themselves at me, practically begging to have wild sex with them for hours on end. Well, at least sometimes they smile at me, and I guess I take it that way. Maybe, I don't know. Maybe I'm reading something into it. I don't really know. The truth is, I don't really have the slightest idea how this whole relationship thing is supposed to work, but I do understand half of it. I know, understand the men's half. You see, I know what men are looking for in a woman. It's very simple. In a woman. It's very simple. Men are looking for a pulse. That's what men are looking for. They're looking for a woman who goes to Nordstrom just to listen to the piano. They're looking for page 7 of the Victoria's Secret winner catalog. They're looking for a woman who doesn't fly off the handle just because you come home a couple of days late. And finally, we're looking for the daughter of a beer distributor. Yeah, I know, guys, I know. I know that sounds good to you, but, you know, you have to realize that this is an ideal. In the real world, the women that you meet, they may not have all the traits that you really want. As a matter of fact, you'll probably run across a lot of women who have some pretty annoying habits. If that's the case, you need to know about the female clinic.
You have some serious female problems, like borrowing his razor.
Ow!
Putting on makeup in the car.
Traffic alert. We've got Wendy applying eyeliner in the Green Lake area, so you might want to take an alternate route today.
And you've just set a new record by being 7 hours late getting ready.
If we leave now, we can still make the fourth quarter.
I'm almost ready.
I need help.
Damn right you do. You need the female clinic, where all those bad female habits will be handled discreetly by our professional staff. At the female clinic, we know how to deal with all the serious problems, like chronic hyena laugh. There's aversion therapy for shoe fetish.
At the end of this hallway is a pair of shoes. Now, these are beautiful shoes, just your size, and they're half off. Now, all you have to do to get them is walk down that hall over the special scale on the floor, which will record your weight and flash it on a billboard downtown for the entire city to see. It's your decision.
have shock therapy for the removal of annoying phrases with treatment tailored to the offense.
See that girl over there? She's not a real blonde. I can tell. Look at those roots.
So, do you still love me? It's just that you haven't said it in so long.
Tell me the truth. Does this make me look fat?
We specialize in the treatment of what's wrong, nothing syndrome.
Okay, go ahead.
What's wrong?
Nothing.
Okay, let's try it one more time, but this time remember that I've got your Nordstrom card and a pair of scissors. Try it again.
What's wrong?
Nothing.
No.
Everything you're wrong. You snore. You never wash out the sink. You chew with your mouth open, and you never call before you come home for dinner.
And try our guaranteed program for perfume overdose.
So if you will, go ahead and apply the perfume, but not too much. Remember, only two small squirts. Good.
Call the female clinic today.
Honey, it wasn't as if I was late on purpose. I got hung up at work, and those things just happen.
You said you would be there at 5 o'clock. No problem.
Look, I said I was sorry. What more do you want me to say?
It's just that it's so inconsiderate.
Honey, I'm sorry. Come on. Please?
Oh, I don't know, Stephanie. I just don't think I'll ever meet a man. Dating is horrible. You never know what you're getting into.
I used to feel the same way, but not anymore. I love dating. I go on dates all the time. And they're always the kind of guy I'm looking for.
Really? How?
It's easy, with the Date of the Month Club. Just look at this ad in our local newspaper.
Wow.
Yes, it's the Date of the Month Club. Just send in this form today. We'll sign you up for the dates of your life with the kind of guys you're looking for. Take advantage of our introductory offer. You get your first 8 dates for just a penny. Look our exciting ad over carefully and pick your men. We've got any kind you're in the mood for. Just select your style. Heavy metal. Jazz. Or country and western.
That's all I have to do? Boy, that sounds like fun.
It is fun. Every month we'll send you a new man. It's just like a record club, only you get guys.
Hi, I'm Mary. Oh, yeah.
Remember, if you're not satisfied for any reason...
Aw, this one skips.
It's not a problem. Just return the defective unit in the convenient shipping crate he came in. Start enjoying a better life of dating right away. Send in your membership application coupon today and start having fun with men again. You'll date a new one every month when you open your box from the Date of the Month Club. Join today.
All right, there you see a clean, modern approach to solving the battle of the sexes. And we need that because without solutions, this whole battle of the sexes thing can spill over into other relationships. I know, because it happened to me once. Take a look.
Well, the whole thing, I mean, they're good live, okay? Every album they've done, I swear, nothing. I'm looking at nothing here. Yeah, I can't stand
it. I like the new album. I think it's okay. It's a little overproduced.
It's okay. Anyway, I gotta split.
Oh,
so
yeah.
You'll send me those. You're gonna get me those copies.
Sure, Steve.
Because I gotta get going.
Yeah, just before you take off, I just wanted to check in with you on something. I mean, like, because we're really good friends, right? I mean,
yeah.
I think you're one of my best friends, really.
Okay, well, you got like a heavy conversation. What are you gonna lay something like
no,
heavy conversation?
No, it's no big deal. It's just I wanted to check in because, you know, like you and Jill are split up.
Oh, right? yeah. And, you know, don't have to listen to that anymore.
Yeah, right.
You know?
Yeah.
That's right. That was a trip.
Yeah, you know? So I just, you know, wanted to make sure that it was okay with you if we saw each other.
Oh, right, like you and Jill.
Yeah.
Okay. I mean, now that would be a trip.
Well, the reason I bring this up is because Jill and I ran into each other at Dave's party on Saturday night.
Dave had a party this last Saturday?
Yeah. I
didn't hear anything about it.
Well, I just wanted to say that since, you know, Jill and I were kind of like together at the party, you know, I didn't want some garbage getting back to you, somebody saying something, because we're, you know, we're friends.
Well, you mean you're together, you took her, it was like a date, you took her to the party?
No.
You're saying you took her to the party?
No, it's not, it wasn't like that. It's that, you know, we just saw each other at the same party, and we were talking, and we, you know, hit it off, one of those things, and, you know, since you guys are split up, and...
Did she tell you that? Did she tell you that we're split up?
Well, yeah, I mean, you know, you're seeing other people.
She said that I was seeing other people?
Yeah.
Because, I mean, I told her that I was going to see, that I might see other people, but I haven't. I mean, I haven't seen other people. Is she seeing other people? Is she seeing other
people? Well, I guess. But she said you had this agreement that worked out, you know.
Okay. If she said so, then I guess we do.
Right.
If that's what she said, then I, you know, it's news to me, but then I guess, you know, that's what she said.
Yeah.
So were you telling me that you took her home? I mean, you take her home from this party?
She asked me for a ride home. I mean, you know, we had talked and stuff.
To her apartment? I mean, you drop her off? Or
You go
with her in there? You went into the apartment?
Yeah.
You take her picture with a Polaroid?
Yeah.
Steve, look. Yeah. You guys are split up.
You're split up and you're seeing other people. I thought it was cool. I didn't think this would be a big deal. I mean, you know, we saw each other. I mean, you know, it's like...
No, okay. I'm sorry. The thing is, I gotta give her a call. I'm going to see her tonight because obviously we got some stuff that we have to work over. So I'm going to get together tonight.
The reason I, you know, mentioned is because... You know, Jill and I, we had plans for tonight. We were going to go to this show thing, but we don't have to do that. I mean,
you're going out with her tonight?
Well, I mean, we don't have to. If it's not cool, I mean, because we're friends, right? That's the most important thing.
Let me get this straight. It's like, you want to be friends here. You're my friend, but you want to go out with my girlfriend.
She's not your girlfriend. Look, like, if this isn't cool, we can work on it.
Oh, cool.
Yeah.
Oh, you want it to be cool. Well, no. Okay. Well, I have to say so because, you know, I think I'm cool.
Good.
You're cool. I mean, sure, everything is cool. I mean, this is a cool place. I mean, I think it's a cool world. I think everything is cool.
Yeah, you want another coffee?
Stay with us because when we come back, we'll have some helpful advice and some warnings for those of you just getting started in the world of relationships.
Actually married.
Yeah.
Hard to believe, isn't it?
I love you, babe. Here's to us.
I love you, too.
Welcome to Boyfriend
and Girlfriend
Basics, the show that tells you what you can really expect from the opposite sex.
Now, we all know that having a special someone in your life can be a fun and fulfilling experience, but there are certain universal behaviors in all relationships, and if you're not prepared for them, you could be in for a nasty surprise.
On our show today, we'll learn to recognize these common behavior patterns so you'll be better equipped to deal with them when they occur.
For example, guys, here's a situation that will occur regularly, and if you're not ready for it, it will destroy you.
Oh, hi, honey. I'm glad you're home. You know, I want to see just how romantic you really are, okay? Okay, let me see here. Oh, here's a good one. If you were a tree, would you be an oak or a willow?
All right, nip this in the bud. Find a way to change the subject fast. Take her out to dinner. Take her to a Patrick Swayze film. Do anything, but do not take a Cosmo quiz. Cosmo does not want you to have a good relationship. They want her to keep buying the magazine so she can figure out what went wrong.
Okay, women, here's something that's liable to be a shock to you if you're not prepared. Please, don't be alarmed. All boyfriends dance this way. I know it's embarrassing, but it's harmless. Thank you, Bill.
Okay, guys, now... A vacation with your girlfriend can be a lot of fun as long as you take a few precautions. For example, watch out that you don't let yourself get into this situation.
Don't you think we could take Waldo with us on the cruise to the Bahamas? It'll be really good, I promise. He'll sleep under the bed the whole time.
Well, I'm sorry, guys. There's no advice for this one. It was your own fault for going out with a girl who had a dog. You should have known better.
Oh, but he was so cute.
Oh, so cute.
Anyway, women, another nasty little behavior commonly exhibited by your boyfriend revolves around his other long-standing relationship.
I can't believe you touched the bias knob. What the hell are you thinking? It took me months to get it just right, and you ruined it.
I cannot stress how important his reaction is in this situation. If your boyfriend lets you even look at that equalizer, it's a clear indication he's falling in love with you. Even so, it's critical that you realize if he ever has to choose between you and his stereo, might as well go ahead and place a personal ad.
Wow, that really didn't seem so out of line to me. But guys, here's a situation that we all have to deal with at some point in a relationship.
Remember that girl at the party with the long blonde hair and the really short black leather skirt and the tight sweater? Did you think she was pretty?
Yes. Okay, see, now this is a trick question. See, there's no correct answer to this question. Anything you say will lead to a huge argument. The only thing to do in this situation is to fake an epileptic seizure. Yeah.
Okay, now, if your boyfriend is feeling a little insecure about his body, it may lead to other bizarre behavior, and here is one of those warning signs.
Okay, hit me. Go ahead. Hit me as hard as you can. I can take it. Come on, hit me. Right there. Come on.
This one is a little tricky because he's not going to let up on this until you actually hit him. So hit him softly. Say, ow. And then go find some jars for him to open.
All right. Finally, for you guys, it's important that you fully understand this situation because it will affect you every day for the rest of your life.
Okay, I'm ready. Wait a minute. This blouse is all wrong. I hate these shoes. Why is my hair doing this? I'll just be a minute.
Okay. Guys, you can't prevent your girlfriend from changing her clothes 27 times before you go out. You've got to work with it. If you want to go to a late movie, you have to tell her that the film starts at 2 p.m. In fact, tell her that every engagement starts at 2 p.m. Then you should be able to get out of the house more or less on time.
Men also have a problem getting ready to go out, but it's a little different. See, anywhere you go, whether it's the movies or an elegant dinner, your boyfriend will pick you up dressed like this. Don't worry. I want you to remember, men are genetically handicapped where clothes are concerned. Just grit your teeth through that first party. You're going to have complete control over this area soon if the relationship lasts. You'll be buying all his clothes, and he'll wear whatever you want as long as you put it on top of the pile.
Okay, so Remember, relationships can be tricky, but with a little preparation, they can be survived.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Saying is, while I understand your needs, I still need some personal space for myself.
Well, I want to support your personal growth. I just think we need to work on our team communication.
Yes, yes. You see how quickly disillusionment can set in. You know, I think that men a lot of times have really unrealistic expectations. You know, we go into this whole thing trying to find somebody who will build our self-esteem, make us feel needed and strong, but all too often, we find ourselves in a relationship like this.
The movie started a half hour ago. Where the hell have you been?
Okay, if you're gonna be that way about it, forget it.
It's time once again for the worst girlfriend in the world. She's the worst girlfriend you've ever had. Every time you think about her, you get mad. The worst girlfriend in the world. A psycho bitch from hell, yes, that's the girl. The worst girlfriend, you know it's true. She thinks it's funny, but the joke's on you. She's the worst girlfriend in the world. Tonight on The Worst Girlfriend in the World, three more guys get messed up and have to go into therapy.
So she walked away from the movie, got in my car, and wrecked it again.
How long have you been seeing her?
About 3 months. Why didn't you see her for that long? The sex was really good. And,
So, what do you think, babe? Pretty nice, huh?
You have a stupid stereo, and I hate this music! And you have an ugly TV!
Honey?
And I hate
darling?
It! I have no
no. Honey, put that down!
I've always hated them!
And then she broke all my records, and she kicked in the TV, and then she set the couch on fire. Again.
How many couches had she set on fire prior to this?
Five.
Why didn't you leave her after she set the first couch on fire?
Well, the sex was really good. And, Honey, what are you doing here?
Well, you left, and I told you I was going to style your hair today.
No, honey.
No,
no
I
no,
wanted
no,
to.
Come on, cut,
no,
cut it out.
Oh. Sorry.
And then she pulled off my toupee and humiliated me in front of everybody.
How was the sex?
Good.
The worst girlfriend you've ever had. Every time you think about her, you get mad. The worst girlfriend in the world. A psycho bitch from hell, yes, that's the girl. The worst girlfriend, you know it's true. She thinks it's funny, but the joke's on you. She's the worst girlfriend in the world. Next week, the worst girlfriend meets Godzilla.
Right after this.
Robert? Hi. Oh, gosh, how are you?
Linda, you look great. Oh, this is Candy.
Hi, Candy?
Mm-hmm.
Nice to meet you. This is Pete.
Hi, Pete. Hi. How you doing?
It's a great day for a walk.
Yeah.
Well, we gotta go.
Yeah.
God, it was great to see you.
Yeah, good to see you. Nice meeting you.
So I told her, hey, drop that zero and get with the hero, you know? Hey, isn't she a little slice of heaven? You know, hey, if I told you you had a beautiful body, would you hold it against me?
Stop.
Huh? Listen, hon, I'm a little short. Can I get another five here?
Oh,
another
sure,
five?
Sure. He's so funny. Well, what do you think? Isn't he cute?
Connie, he's a jerk.
Oh, I know he's kind of boyish and playful, but...
While you were in the bathroom, he asked me for a date in front of Bob.
Yeah.
Oh, no. Not again. Why does this keep happening to me?
I used to date creeps all the time, too, until I tried Jerkoderm.
Jerkoderm? Oh, the patch.
Jerkoderm is a painless skin patch that's been clinically proven to reduce the craving for relationships with attractive, yet rotten men. Jerks. Here's how it works. In a typical female, sensory input from the jerk enters from the eyes and the ears, bypassing the brain function entirely. It then passes through the libido and exits through the mouth in the form of an affirmative answer to any question. The Jerkoderm patch releases a chemical which activates the brain's own natural jerk defense mechanism, allowing the female to make a more appropriate response to the situation.
Hey, baby. Say, are you a model? Those eyes are incredible. Can I buy you a drink?
Well, thank you. Actually, I did do a little modeling at one time. Thanks, Jerkoderm.
For information on how Jerkoderm can help you, call 1-800-DUMP-HIM. And now for men, try Bitch Pack.
That was Almost Live presents the Battle of the Sexes, and I think that hopefully what we've done in the last hour or so, I know it seems to have just flown by, but hopefully we've solved problems. Men, women in the audience, do you think we've solved anything here?
No.
No. No, I guess they're probably right, but at least I hope we haven't kicked up any new sort of problems, which reminds me, I know this is running a little bit late, so honey, if you're watching, we were running a little late. I'm sorry. I'm going to be right home, okay? I'm going home now. I'm not going to stop by any place. I'm coming right home. So I'll see you. Bye-bye.